point in your bird feeding where you get a little possessive of your birds, you get a little tired of birds that probably shouldn't be around stealing their food, or squirrels stealing their food, you want to do something about it. Okay, by birds that shouldn't be around, I'm speaking of the alien species, the European starling and the house sparrow. Those species were introduced into North America over 100 years ago by people who really didn't have very much of a science background, and unfortunately they've changed the North American ecosystem forever. They cover the entire continent practically. So we don't want to encourage those animals because they will take nesting cavities away from our native birds. They cause a lot of problems. Also, they cause a lot of problems with our food supply. So we don't want to really encourage them to eat our seed either. So what can we do? Okay, well, one of the worst things that can happen, of course, is rain, snow, and ice, because most of us are going to feed during the winter. You can feed all year round if you want. Winter's a favorite. So a super easy way to protect your seed is to buy a baffle. Okay, now you can buy the really fancy ones. They're expensive. They're going to last you a long, long time. So you can make some homemade baffles. Really easy. The first one is one of my favorites. Okay, for those of you who have these 4-gallon or 5-gallon water jugs, these make perfect baffles. Okay, you can cut off the bottom and make a long baffle, or you can cut them a little shorter for a short baffle, or you can cut them midway. These are fabulous. Cut them to the length you want. You're going to use box cutters. Be careful, kids, do not use these by yourselves. These are very dangerous. You want to have a parent or an adult help you with these. You're going to cut carefully and slowly where you would like it, and then you have a baffle. And all you do is, it's a little bit of a push, but you can push a bungee cord up through there. Hang your feeder, we'll show you an example, hang your feeder underneath, and now not only is it protected mostly from the rain and weather, you'll get a little bit of moisture down there, but not much, but if a squirrel tries to jump on this, he's going to slide right off, okay? Especially if you make this a little bit longer. These are wonderful, they're free, ask your neighbors, okay? Peek at people's recycling bins, okay? But these are free and they're wonderful. A lot of businesses might even give these to you, okay? Especially if they come from a store, because the store ones are not refillable. Okay, there are professional companies out there, those are refillable. Plus they're almost impossible to cut with a box cutter. So get the ones that you would get from a store, like a grocery store. Okay, so this is a really great thing to have. Another thing is, go to the store, get yourself a nice, great, big cake. Caramel cake, carrot cake, chocolate cake. So it has this nice high dome. You can see how high this dome is. That's about 6-inch dome. Okay, and it's about maybe 10, 12 inches in diameter. Okay, these are fantastic baffles. Okay, so what you do is you take your box cutter and you just punch down through. Gotta be careful, keep your hands out of the way. Make an X. Okay, don't try to cut a hole, just make an X. Okay, just a little X, nothing big. Now, depending on how you use this, you can put maybe a bungee cord down through there. You can poke up your handle through this. Okay, I didn't make this quite large enough. I'll have to cut a little bit more. It'll actually rest on the cap here. Still very easy to fill your feeder. And it really deters the house sparrows. House sparrows and European starlings don't like their wings hitting this plastic. That unnerves them. Our native birds, they don't mind at all. So that makes a great free baffle. And one time I actually saw my neighbor, I thought he was looking at my homemade baffle, and he actually was trying to figure out what kind of cake I had bought and eaten. So that was his only concern. Another baffle you can make, and this is great for your feeding pole. You want to have this around your pole. You also want to have this around your nest box poles. Never ever put a nest box or your feeders on a pole that's not protected by a baffle. Now this one is a little small. I suggest a little bit wider diameter, but this is absolutely fine. This one's been around a long time. This is stovepipe. And what you want to do, you want to poke through, you can drill through about maybe 1, 2, 3, 4, the shape of a cross, okay? And then you're going to put this over the pole. And I like to tie it up with some wire. You're gonna put some hardware cloth on top of it so that a squirrel can't run up through there and just poke his way right out the top. You wanna have hardware cloth there. And you wanna have this so that it swings. Okay, you don't wanna have it nice and stiff like that. That's not the best. You wanna have it so it wobbles, because it's not just your squirrels that are gonna come around and try to get your seed, it's your raccoons at night. Okay? And they are expert climbers. An average raccoon has a arm stretch capability of over 20 inches. That's why a lot of baffles on nest boxes don't work if they're not large enough. The raccoons can get past them, but they do not like the swinging of a baffle. That's just something they do not care for. Okay, so I'd really recommend always get a baffle. And one thing you can use, if you have squirrels that are on the ground, and you've got ground feeders like juncos, American tree sparrows, song sparrows. Yeah, those are wonderful, wonderful native species. By the way, our sparrows are not related to house sparrows. House sparrows are actually a weaver finch, and they originate over in the African continent in North Africa. If you have squirrels that are just hogging away, I mean, we're talking squirrels that are gaining 3 pounds a week. Okay, get yourself some cayenne pepper. Sprinkle it out there on the seed. Most squirrels are deterred by this. The birds don't care. It's not going to hurt the birds at all. The squirrels don't like the hot pepper taste, so they'll leave it alone and go somewhere else. They'll go to your neighbor's yard, which is a good thing. Maybe not for your neighbor. Does it hurt the birds? Again, no, it won't. But I do have to tell you that some squirrels get a taste for this. But most of the time, the squirrels are going to ease off eating your seed. They'll pick through it a little more carefully because of this hot pepper. So that's a real good deterrent if you want to try it.